Welcome back. You're watching Business Lunch. At this point in the market, Nifty 50 comfortably above that 10,300 level. Fair bit of a recovery seen there. A lot of it is owed also to the rupee recovery that we have seen just recently. But TCS as well as Infosys are the biggest draggers. As rupee recovers, they have gone down further, and Infosys is one of the biggest draggers. But what's really pulling the market up in the last few minutes of trade has been ONGC and the rest of the oil marketing pack. Two stocks which come on my radar in the smaller pack and the larger universe is Asahi India as well as Aban Offshore. In an otherwise very weak sentiment, these two stocks have just spiked up in the recent times. As far as ONGC is concerned, it's also to do with the government officials' clarification coming in on no subsidy burden on the upstream companies. In fact, talking more about that, my colleague Sapna Das joins in with the key takeaways from the finance ministry briefing on the overall economy, the rupee levels, the oil, as well as where we are headed. Sapna.
Hi. So first, starting off with the upstream question that has been doing the rounds since, you know, so many days, a very clear indicator that the government has absolutely no intention of involving the upstream companies in any kind of a subsidy sharing burden. Now, we had put out, the fresh demand number in terms of the additional compensation that OMCs have raised to the government in terms of LPG and kerosene subsidies. Around 12,000 crores of additional tab is what they have put in. So keeping that in mind, you know, there was this question arising that, you know, at some point in time, will we do that? Absolutely no intention on part of the government, absolutely nothing, no thinking on that. So that's, you know, there's clarity on that front, and this should be factored in. In fact, the call here appears to be that the Brent is expected to be at least range bound, the outer limit at least the internal government estimates over here is $5 a barrel, the Brent price basically. So expected to be range bound, if not lower, and this is expected to have a rub off impact on the India rupee, and that's what we are seeing as of now. So that's one big clarification. The second also indications coming in that possibly the space, you know, for further import compression may be very, very limited. So we are not very sure as to, you know, all that expectation of a second list coming in. Only 19 items were there in the first list, and most of them were not like very heavy, quote unquote, heavy items or something like that. So now the indication is that possibly, you know, the maneuverability or the elbow room in terms of further import compression or higher tariffs on certain other items like aluminium and steel was still being spoken about. So it appears to be a bit of a dance squib on that front. That's the second indication that's come in. Third, and equally important, though the indication is that you know, possibly looking at the way the crude is behaving right now, and that's going to be a huge comfort for India, also indicating that the future prices probably, you know, have factored it in the winter demand that's going to come in and all that. But very quickly, so in terms of the strategy on CAD, BOP, as well as the rupee, that's ready. NRI bond is an option. That's the clear indication coming in. The only point is that possibly, we may not see anything immediate. In fact, what we have been told is it can happen in a day, in a month, or it may not happen at all. So these are takeaways.
Okay, thanks a lot for that, Sapna. Well, the oil and gas stocks are just surging now. Look at HPCL. It's up almost 15%, and all of this just in the last half an hour. GAIL, ONGC following suit, but the move on HPCL, pretty volatile the last few days, actually. But let's move away from equities for a bit. Cyclone Titli.